वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एल के त्रिपाठी इज हियर, एस एस टी टीचर फ्रॉम LPM पब्लिक स्कूल। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी शैल स्टडी द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ द सेम चैप्टर, दैट इज हिस्ट्री। द टॉपिक इज फ्रॉम मुगल दिल्ली टू कॉलोनियल न्यू दिल्ली, ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ एन अर्बन सेंटर। Now the transformation takes place. Mughal Delhi converted in colonial New Delhi. Colonial rule converted the old name of Delhi, now became New Delhi. This was a very important urban center for the British. During the early medieval period, Delhi gained prominence as a major seat of power during the reigns of the Tomar and Chauhan Rajput dynasty. The early identity of Delhi was very glorious. Two dynasties, powerful dynasties, ruled over Delhi, and they are considered, they are respected to the last Hindu rule of Delhi, Tomar and Chauhan Rajput dynasty. Subsequently, as you have read in class 7, five dynasties of the Sultanate period developed it into the most important city in the Indian subcontinent. Delhi has been the most prominent center for the rulers. During the Sultanate period also, the five dynasties of Sultanate period ruled over Delhi and kept it as a main center of their rule. In 1639, the Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan built a city here, which was named Shah Jahanabad. During this period, Shah Jahan, the Mughal ruler, built Shah Jahanabad. It consisted of a fort and palace complex, and the city adjoining it. Its other major landmarks were the Chandni Chowk and Jama Masjid. The largest mosque in India, Jama Masjid, is the largest in India. All the major announcements for the Muslims are done from here. So the credit goes to Shah Jahan to construct Delhi in various way. He built so many palaces, Chandni Chowk, Jama Masjid, Red Fort also he constructed. All such types of construction he made. Chandni Chowk had streets broad enough for royal processions to pass through. The Lal Killa or Red Fort, made of red sandstone, contained the palace complex. To its west lay the walled city with 14 gates. It had the 14 gates. It was known as the Wall City. That is very famous fort of Delhi, Red Fort. The credit goes to Shah Jahan to build this Red Fort. Now, colonial Delhi. We shall see the colonial Delhi, what type of city they constructed. Shah Jahanabad was a large and thriving city before the British conquered it in 1803. Delhi was captured by the British in 1803, and before that it was undoubtedly a thriving city, very large, very broad, beautiful, having old tradition and architecture. The British lived here alongside the wealthier natives in the walled city till 1857. They learned to enjoy Urdu and Persian culture and poetry and participated in local festivals. The emperor promptly granted Dara Shikoh's library near Kashmiri Gate to the British, where the British residency camp of a very famous library of Dara Shikoh, you know, was the brother of Aurangzeb, but he was killed by Aurangzeb assumed the throne of Mughal dynasty. The emperor promptly granted Dara Shikoh's library near Kashmiri Gate to the British, where the British residency camp up. But all this changed after the revolt of 1857. First of all, Bahadur Shah II was exiled to Rangoon. All the changes in Delhi came up during the British rule. As a result, when the revolt of 1857 took place, the last Mughal emperor of Mughal dynasty, Bahadur Shah II, was captured, arrested, and sent to Rangoon, that was known as Kala Pani those days, that is, in Andaman and Nicobar. His court was dismantled and several of his palaces were razed to the ground. बहुत सारे palaces को ढहा दिया गया अंग्रेजों के द्वारा और उनकी court को dismantle कर दिया गया, ख़त्म कर दिया गया. They cleared the area around the Red Fort for security reasons. The palaces, the courts, the buildings surrounding the Red Fort were destroyed for the security point of view and built barracks inside the fort for their troops. इस Red Fort के अंदर उन्होंने बैरक बना लिया जिसमें इनकी सेनाएँ रहती थीं. In the 1870s, the western walls of Shahjahanabad were broken to establish railway lines and allow the city to expand beyond its previous walls. 1870 में जो पश्चिमी दीवार शाहजहांबाद की थी उसको तोड़ दिया गया था और इधर से रेलवे लाइन बनाई गई और सिटी को एक्सपेंड कर दिया गया. जो प्रीवियस वाल, जो पहले की वाल थी उसके बाहर इस तरह से शाहजहांबाद को डिस्ट्रॉय कर दिया गया अंग्रेज़ों के द्वारा. द ब्रिटिश मैगजीन एमुनिशन स्टोर हाउस, द टेलीग्राफ मेमोरियल एंड वाइसरेगल लॉज द सर्किट हाउस, द कोरोनेशन दरबार मेमोरियल वेयर सम ऑफ द बिल्डिंग्स इरेक्टेड बिफोर एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिसेस शिफ्टेड टू दिल्ली द न्यू कैपिटल इन 1932. द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट आल्सो एक्सपेरिमेंटेड इन 1888 with a scheme for the extension of walls cities as they were very congested. द लाहौर गेट इम्प्रूवमेंट स्कीम वॉज प्लान बाय रॉबर्ट क्लार्क एज द नेम सजेस्ट इन लाहौर. द मेन आइडिया ऑफ द स्कीम वॉज टू ड्रा रेजिडेंट्स अवे फ्रॉम द ओल्ड सिटी टू ए न्यू टाइप ऑफ मार्केट स्क्वायर विद शॉप्स ऑल अराउंड. बट somehow this development remained incomplete and failed in its efforts to decongest the old wall city. In 1936 the Delhi Improvement Trust was set up and it built areas like Daryaganj South Forest people. It was also an attempt to draw people away from the congested city of Old Delhi. Now the next, shifting the capital. How did they shift their capital and where? In 1911, when King George V was crowned in England, a darbar was held in Delhi to celebrate the occasion. At this darbar, the British announced their decision to shift the capital of India from Calcutta to Delhi. Why did the British do so? Right after supporting the revolt of 1857, the British had realized the symbolic importance of Delhi. They wanted the people of Delhi to forget the Mughal Emperor, whom they still saw as their leader. This was why, after the revolt of 1857, many spectacular events like the Darbar, which Viceroy Lutyen organized to acknowledge Queen Victoria as the Empress of India, was held at Delhi. That's why Delhi Darbar was set up there. In 1932, New Delhi, which was planned and built by two architects, Sir Edwin Lutyen and Herbert Baker, was inaugurated as the capital of British India. New Delhi was constructed as a 10 square mile city on Raisina Hills. The two great architects who designed New Delhi had different but complementary vision, though two architects were there who constructed Delhi, but their vision was the same. Lutyen sought to borrow from architectural designs of different countries, and Baker wanted to integrate local elements in his designs. In this way, we have come to know about the Delhi Darbar, New Delhi. In the next video, we shall see the next. Till then, goodbye.